In third part of this lesson, or in the third lesson, I will show you how to operate on splines with Inkscape. What are splines? Well, in Inkscape, any object, for example text, could be converted into a spline path, object to path. Now, it's not an editable text anymore. It's a set of control points and segments in between. What we can do with these points? Of course, we can move them, right? We can delete them. And we can separate one point, one control point, into two with this creation. And now, instead of having one point, we have two points here. Okay, now we can make a contour over this object, not that thick, let's make it thinner. And you can see here, since I split one point into two and separated them, I have no line here. I can connect them again, select both of them, and transform two points into one. Okay. Those are simple operations. Now let me remove all this and create a spline object. Using this tool, B, you can either select this icon or type B. Okay, I draw an object, for example two houses, and you can see that all segments are straight. If you want to draw something curved, we select this tool, and by drawing, we click on control, and we will this way, we will draw something. So now I click control, I click left mouse button, and I make an object with tangent, which I define. Now click F2, control points, select O, control A, and I can transform this curved object into straight, half piecewise linear object. Okay, if I want to connect this, I will need to select these two points and transform two points into one. Okay, now I can fill it. Of course, it's an object that intersects itself. Let me correct it. Okay, now this is a piecewise linear boundary. And if I want to round it, I can select all, control A, select all control points, and click on this button. It will round everything. It will smooth everything, no kink points anymore. But any segment, so I select this segment between the two control points, any segment could be converted into straight segment again. Okay, and this segment, for example, I want to make it straight as well. Right? Let me remove this object. Another thing that we can do, we can every control point could be either it could be a corner, kink point, or it can be a point with a tangent. Tangent, we can control the direction. Or it can be king point with different tangents on both sides. On the left, on the right, we have independent tangent vectors. Okay. If you click on the any control point with the with control, it will make it smooth again. It will add a common tangent in this point. Okay, let's transform it into again the piecewise linear boundary. And for example, we want to add tangent on this point. So to do so, we need to click Shift and draw and drag a line. Okay, here again we would like to have a tangent in on the left side of this point. I click Shift and I drag this tangent vector. The same here, Shift, drag, and so on. Alright, now for example we would like to add a hole. Make a circle here, select both objects, path, difference, oops, path, difference doesn't want to make, let's color this, path, difference. Okay, now it's done, we have a hole, right, we can modify it. So now it's a single path object, which could be split into two paths if you do path break apart. So now let's bring this object on the forefront. We made an independent path which could be modified, could be operated independently. Okay, let's remove everything. Let's create a new rectangle. And we would like to make an undulated surface, for example, on this side. We select everything, path, object to path. And here on this boundary, we select this segment. We would like to add more points. We add more points. And we will make we select every second. Oops, I didn't select every second. So I rounded everything, but now this segment and this segment and this segment I want to remain straight. And this one was not selected, straight. So now we have this shape. On the lower side we would like to make the same thing. To do so we duplicate this object, Ctrl D. We flip it. Move it, and now we path union make a single object. Okay, what else can we do with splines? We can simplify this line. It's an important operation. I will demonstrate later, but now let me simply show it on the spline. We can draw arrows. The size of the arrow actually is proportional to the thickness of the line. So by changing the thickness, we change the size of the markers. And at every intermediate point, we would like to add some markers as well. For example, this one. Let's make the spline smooth. Okay, that's it. Often, if you would like to draw some symmetric objects, it's a good idea to draw just a half of the object. For example, by the way, to remove the last point, you type backspace, it removes last points. Double click stops the spline. Now I'd like to draw a heart, and these two points I would like to be aligned vertically. I select the alignment menu and align. Okay, now I'd like to round here, and here I'd like to make it this. Okay. Now we have a half of the heart. Ctrl D to duplicate. Flip horizontally. Enable. Now I would like to combine these two splines. To do so, I do pass, combine, and these points I will glue, and these two points I will. So now we have a perfectly symmetric heart, which we can color in red. Okay. One more example about splines that I would like to show you. Let's take a raster image. We embedded the Inkscape precise content. Okay. So this results of some numerical simulations, and I would like to select all blue spots on this figure. To do so, I would like to draw a contour around these blue spots. To do so, I will pass trace bitmap. I will do multicolor according to colors. Three colors would be enough for me. Apply. So I created a vector object based on my raster image. Okay, I ungroup everything. I remove this one and this one. And so what I have this blue spots only. And every spot I would like to draw a contour around. So I click with the shift on the black color. And you can see, okay, now I have the boundary, the border of the spots shown in the black. But it's very kinky, this boundary, not beautiful one. I like to smooth it a little bit. To do so, there is a simple tool, pass, simplify. And for one iteration already, the shape was nicely simplified, and it's enough for my purpose. Let me simply change the color of this stuff, point white. Okay, that's how we can use the simplify option. If it's not enough, of course, you can do some manual post treatment to simplify it a bit more. Example, this we will remove.